design. The last class I forgot to summarize the chapter. Today we can summarize the chapter first, and then we can start the next chapter. Okay. Okay, the chapter is constitutional design, and we begin the chapter with the introduction to constitution, or how to define a constitution. How to define the constitution? It is a set of written rules that are accepted by all the peoples that are living together in a country. Constitution, always remember, it's a set of rules that, based on that rules, a country will works, or a government will form, the people will live. So it is considered as a supreme law which explains the relationship among the people and the people and the government. So how to define constitution is, it's a set of written rules that are accepted by all the people living together in a country. Then another important point is, why do we need a constitution? What is the importance of a constitution for a country? 4 points are there. The first one is, it generates a degree of trust and coordination that is necessary for different kinds of people to live together in a country. A country include the different kinds of people. Always remember that in a country, the different kinds of people are living. Maybe they are different in their religion, caste, or geographical differences. Gender differences. So we need a law. It generates a degree of trust. Constitution generates a degree of trust and coordination that is necessary for different peoples to live together. Second one is, it specifies how the government will be constituted and who will have the power to take which decision. The organs of the government, and which organ have the power to take which decision. All the things are clearly explained in the constitution. The next one, it lays down the limits on the power of the government and tells us what's the right of the citizens. It explains the citizens, example, fundamental rights. And also, it put a limit on the power of the government. Or sometimes, there is a chance to misuse the power. So it put a limit on the power of the government and lay down the rights of the citizens. And the last one is, it expresses the aspiration of the people about creating a good society. So these are the 4 important points. If a question is there, why do we need a constitution? Our answer must be these points. It generates a degree of trust and coordination that is necessary for different kinds of people to live together. It specifies how the government will be constituted and who will have the power to take which all decisions. Then it lays down the limits on the power of government and tells us what the right of the citizens. And the last one is, it expresses the aspirations of the people about creating a good society. Then, these 2 sentences, you made mistakes in the last exam also. All countries that have constitution are not necessarily democratic. That means, for example, a country, China, it have its own constitution, but it's not a democratic country. But all the countries that are democratic will definitely have a constitution. All the democratic countries like India, USA. So all these democratic countries have a constitution of their own. All the democratic countries have a constitution. All the countries that are democratic will have a constitution. But if a country have a constitution, that doesn't mean it's a democratic one. All the countries have its own constitution, but a democratic country definitely need a constitution. Then, after the French Revolution, Oh, and the American America also gave its own constitution. French Revolution, the French people approved their own constitution. So after that, it became a practice that all the democratic countries have a constitution when it become independent. Then coming to Indian Constitution, making of Indian Constitution. It is not an easy affair to make a constitution for a country like India. Why? The making of Indian Constitution is a huge and diverse country like India was not easy affair. Why? It is because at that time, the people of India were emerging from the status of a citizen to subjects. And also at that time, the partition of India happened. India, the country is divided into two, India and Pakistan. And it is a decision, the British left it to the princely states to decide whether they want to join in India or Pakistan or to remain independent. So that is also a very difficult task about the future of the country. So when the constitution was being written, the makers of the constitution had anxious about the present and the future of the country. This can also be a question. Why? Or explain. When the constitution was being written, the makers of the constitution had anxiety about the present and future of the country. Do you agree with the statement? Give reason. Or why? The makers of the constitution had anxious about the present and future of the Indian constitution. The points are, at that time, this point also you can write, because it's a huge and diverse country. But a question like this, the making of Indian constitution is a huge, for a huge and diverse country like India was not an easy affair. Why? You can add all other points. Okay? Any point from this may be a question. Clear, children? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
So if a question is like this, the making of a constitution for a huge and diverse country like India was not an easy affair. Give reason or explain or why. You can write this, because the people are emerging from the status of subject to that of citizen. Then the partition of the country. And also the decision is left to the princely states to join whether in India or Pakistan or to remain independent. The question is like that. The constitution was being written. The makers of the constitution had anxious about the present and future of the country. Do you agree? Do you agree with the statement? And give reason. So from this portion, the question may be two types. One may be the makers of the constitution had anxious about the present and future of the country. Do you agree with the statement? Give reason. You can write, because it's a huge and diverse country. The emerging the status from that of a subject to that of citizen, the partition of the country. And also, the decision is left to the princely states to decide whether they want to join in India, Pakistan, or to remain independent. So, question may be two types from this portion.
Yes,
then, coming to the path of Indian Constitution. Our national movement, it is not only against a foreign struggle. We want to regenerate, or we want to transform our country, especially our society and our politics. Then, the experiences gained by the Indians in the working of the legislative institution proved to be very useful for the country in setting up its own institutions. Our leaders are inspired by many of the ideals like French Revolution, parliamentary democracy in Britain, and Bill of Rights in USA. When we are analyzing the constitution, we can see the impact of all these in our constitution. From USA, we adopted the fundamental rights for the parliamentary form of government. We adopted from Britain And also from French Revolution, we adopted the concept of liberty. So when we are analyzing our constitution, we can see that there is a reflection of all these in our own constitution. So the first, the constitution for the country was drafted by, don't forget the name, Motilal Nehru and the 8 other Congress leaders in the year 1928. In 1928, Motilal Nehru and the other 8 Congress leaders, they framed a constitution for the country. They drafted a constitution for the country. And the outline of this constitution is prepared by the International Congress in its Karachi session. Sometimes one mark will be there from this portion. Who drafted the constitution for the country in 1928? Motilal Nehru. In which year Motilal Nehru constituted a draft constitution for the country in 1928? Then, coming to the Indian constitution. It held the Constituent Assembly. The Constitution of India is framed as per which plan? The Cabinet Mission Plan in 1946. The Constituent Assembly of the country is framed, set up under the Cabinet Mission Plan in 1946. The Assembly consists of 389 members. The total number of members in 1946 when the Constituent Assembly was set up is 389. But the Constituent Assembly that wrote Indian Constitution include 299 members. Then it held its first meeting in 1946. At that time, it included 389 members and it elected Dr. Rajendra Prasad as its chairman. Who's the chairman of the Constituent Assembly? It's Dr. Rajendra Prasad. The chairman of drafting committee is Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Then the Constituent Assembly is divided into two, the Constituent Assembly of India and Pakistan. And the Constituent Assembly that wrote the Indian Constitution had 299 members. The Assembly adopted the Constitution. Last class also I told you, don't be confused with this. The Assembly adopted the constitution in 26 November 1949, but it came into effect in January 26, 1950. The 2 years are different. It adopted or enacted. The constitution is adopted or enacted in the year 1949. But it came into effect in 1950. Always remember, our Republic Day, it came into effect. Constitution came into effect in our Republic Day. Then, why should we accept the constitution made by the Constituent Assembly more than 70 years? It's also a question. Now also, we are following the same constitution. Why? It's because the first reason is no large social groups or political parties ever questioned the legitimacy of the constitution. No one challenged or no one questioned. Melvin, sit proper, dear.
Ma'am, I can't on my
sit proper. So no one questioned the legitimacy of our constitution. But in many of the countries, most of the political parties or the social groups are not accepting the constitution, or it is existing merely as a paper in many of the countries. But in the case of India, no one challenged the legitimacy of Indian constitution. Then it represents the people of India. Constituent Assembly include the members from different geographical area, from different occupation, from different culture, different classes and all. So it represents the people of India. Then third reason is it worked in a systematic and open manner. Our constituent assembly worked in a systematic and open manner. That first they came up with some common principles, then it will be there for a discussion. Several rounds of thorough discussions take place, and each close by close they discussed it, and more than 2000 amendments were made at that time. The time when the constitution was written itself, they made around 2000 amendment in that, and all the things, what all things they are spoken there are recorded there. What all things they are spoken and presented become a record there, and that is called as the constituent assembly debates. What do you mean by constituent assembly debates? Every document presented and the words spoken in the constituent assembly is recorded and preserved. That is called as the constituent assembly debates. And when it is printed, it includes 12 bulky volumes. That's why they made around 2000 amendments. The 2000 amendments were made because what all things they discussed it close by close, and if any changes are needed, they made the changes that time itself. Then coming to the constitution. This is the preamble of the constitution. It includes almost all the important values. When we are reading the preamble itself, we can understand the values which the Indian constitution is giving more importance. The major terms are sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic, republic. Sovereign means there is no external power. Both internal and external are decided by the country itself. Socialist means there should not be any inequality in economic field. Secular means anyone can follow any religion. There is no official religion for the country. Democratic means it's an elected government. The representatives of the people are ruling the country. Justice in all fields, economic, political, and social justice. Liberty of freedom of speech and expression. Equality, economic, political, and social equality. And fraternity means it's a concept of universal brotherhood. Where that means we all are belonging to the one and the same family. Then the another important term is constitutional amendments. Changes that are made to the constitution is called as a constitutional amendment. It is not a static one. Our constitution is not a static law. So as per the time, if we need any changes, we can make the changes. These changes are called as constitutional amendments. There are three categories of amendment. One is simple majority. Second one is special majority amendment. And the third one is, it's a very difficult amendment because it needs a special majority, and also it needs the approval of a minimum 50% of the state legislatures. This much we discussed in this chapter. Then have you heard about, children, the Article 370? Article 370. This is a special article in the constitution which give a special privilege to Jammu Kashmir. Have you heard about Jammu Kashmir?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Actually, it was not a part of India or not a part of Pakistan. It remained independent. But the last year, this Article 370 amendment, or that article gave a special status to the Jammu Kashmir. That's why now we have two more.
States.
Union territories. Now this Article 370 is not valid because that is a constitutional amendment. An amendment made in the constitution and we changed it. Okay. Happened today, the rain is, no rain is there, so today network issue will not be there for many of you. Turn on your videos. That's all about the chapter, and our next chapter is electoral politics. I think it's a very interesting chapter to you because what all things we know is given there. Have you heard about election?
Yes.
Election.
Yes.
Yes. Then how we are conducting the election?
Yes, ma'am.
The procedures we are doing before the election, after the election, how to form the government. See, how we are, what do you mean by election? What do you mean by election?
Representative.
The representatives
are elected.
Be louder.
The representatives are
selecting a representative. Yes, selecting a representative through the
selecting some people for the.
Once again, Melvin.
Selecting some people or a person to guide.
Okay, then the next month or October something, I think so, the election is coming. Have you noticed it?
No.
Which election is there in the November or October? Maybe in October.
Ma'am, Panchayat election.
Very good, Panchayat election. Panchayat election is coming. So today also in the news I heard, those who want to include their name in the voters list, they can do it. Voters list. What do you mean by voters list?
The list of
name of
the list of representatives.
The list of
the people who vote.
The people who are voting. That is included in the voters list. Have you ever entered into an electoral booth?
No.
No one?
No.
Have you ever seen the voting machine?
Yes.
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 Then related to election, then what all things you know? For conducting an election, we need a voters list, right? From the name, those whose name are there in the voters list only can vote. Have you ever seen? Because the next 2 months, if you are watching, you can see that all these things happening in our area. That is the coming election, about the election procedures and how the people will vote and how the candidates will work. What do you mean by election? What is the importance of election? And all the things we are discussing in this chapter. This chapter, I think you know the concept. Everything we know because it's related to our daily affairs. Election, electoral politics, why we need election, how to select the representatives. Then, what is the importance of election in a democratic country? About the constituencies, voters list, reserved constituency. All these things are familiar to us, and also same way the next month we can, when a newspaper I saw, I read a news related to the property right. Have you noticed that?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Just go through that, okay? If you are reading the newspaper today, you hear the news or reading the newspaper, you can see that the voters list. The election commission. Who is conducting the election?
Government.
Government.
A separate body is there to conduct the election. Who is that?
Election
commission. Election commission is there to conduct the election. Okay. So all these things we can discuss in this chapter, and we can start the chapter in the next day. Okay. Okay, then thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye.